Search the internet or your library for information on proportions of the human face. You'll find a ton of information, but each source seems to say something different. This is video one in a series of videos which will make you less confused about the proportions of the human face. You will be less confused because I will give you proof that a lot of the formulas that you learned for portrait drawing were wrong. At the end of this video, I will give you a new formula to help you draw the human face from memory. In this experiment, I've taken the most common formulas for facial proportion and tested them on a group of people in a similar pose. I used a computer program to help me take accurate measurements. I made sure that my control group was comprised of both males and females and were of many different races. So let's get started with a very common proportion rule. The question is it one eye length between each eye? The answer, as you can see, is yes. But this was the only rule that I found to be universally correct. Let's stick with the eyes for question two. It's often stated that it's 5 eye lengths across the face. It turns out that for 9 of the 10 people that I tested, that rule is incorrect. I found that if you included the width of the ear to the face, then that rule would be closer to true, but definitely not universal. Of the control group, only one person had a fit, so we can conclude that this proportion does exist, but it does not fit the majority of people, and thus shouldn't be part of a drawing formula. I recently saw on the internet that the outer corners of the nose should line up with the inner corners of the eye. Only 1 of 10 people that I tested proved that proportion to be true. There were also 2 people who came close. Once again, we can conclude that this proportion does exist, but it does not fit the majority of people and thus shouldn't be part of a drawing formula. Most often, the outer nose lined up where the tear ducts meet the white of the eye. For the record, I hope that the lady in the bottom left never catches a cold. Question 4 asks, does the pupil and iris line up with the corners of the mouth when the face is calm? I will warn you that this was the most difficult to answer because the mouth is the most variable feature of the face. The shape slightly differs from person to person, and it moves a lot. I found that only 2 people had eyes and mouths, which lined up perfectly. But everybody, except the gentleman on the top left, was extremely close. So, despite the results, I would include this measurement for a general face proportion formula, but I would also be sure to observe the person who I was drawing to get my answer. It is also important to note that 8 of the 10 people's mouths fit between the lines drawn down from the middle of each eye. Since question 5 is related to the placement of the ears, I changed a few of the photos in the control group. In order to gauge this, I had to be able to see the ears clearly. Most portrait formulas state that the ears go from the top of the eye to the bottom of the nose. This turned out to be a pretty accurate statement. Question 6 is directly related to question 5 and asks whether the nose and ears are generally the same size. Although there were only 2 exact measurements, every other person was close in measurement. So we can conclude that it's accurate to say that the ear generally goes between the upper eye and the bottom of the nose and is very close in height to the nose. Now let's test the most common and controversial face proportion question. Are the eyes at the exact halfway point of the head? You will find top results on the search engines stating that this is the case. I once had a teacher who insisted this and took off points to any student who disagreed with him. If he only did his homework, the eyes are not at the center of the head. The actual middle of the head is just below the orbits of each eye. There was only one person whose eyes were measured as the center of the head, and of course, it was Macaulay Culkin. Now it's time for me to give you a easy to remember and very workable formula. And you'll actually be surprised, even though I pointed out so many differences between the rules that exist and what I'm giving you, I'm going to keep this pretty similar to what you may know already. Step 1 is to just start out with an oval. Now, here's the big change. I made the line a little bit higher, and I think a lot of us do it naturally. So instead of putting it right at the middle of the oval, make sure that you put it slightly higher than that. And now I'm putting in four dashes, and I'm evenly spacing these dashes. They're going to be the two eyes, one eye length in between the two eyes. And as we know, five eye lengths is too much, across the face. That would be a very wide face. But, if you include the ears, five eye lengths is okay as a generalization. And remember, this is just a generalization. I am putting in a very crude nose right now, and I am making sure that it goes outside of the inner corners of the eyes. Remember, it lines up with the tear, where the tear ducts meet the white of the eye. I am putting in a rainbow shape for the top of the eye and a circle inside there from the midpoint of the eye, from the iris, the pupil and iris. If we drew a line straight down, the mouth should fit right in between that. I'm not mentioning the spacing of the eyes and the nose and the eyes and the mouth too much because that's very variable. But in most cases, it's a rectangle. It's a very square-like rectangle. It's not exactly a square, but it's just a little bit longer than a square. So you could use that as a guide. The ears, they go from the top of the eyes to the bottom of the nose, and there is some variation with that. So that's the general face. That's just a review. I hope that this helped. There is a part two in this video that I'm going to go a lot more in detail. I'm going to draw that figure. I have the human proportion guide and the differences between male and female skulls. Hope you watch them all. Thanks for watching.